You said last week that Roger Goodell's apology was almost like a slap in the face. Now he's encouraging team to sign Kaepernick. Does that change anything for you?
No, I think in hindsight, we look back and we think, like, what if we would have made this stance 3 years ago? Mm-hmm. Could we have stopped more police violence? Would there have been less death on the streets of America right now? So although he's trying to do what's politically correct at this moment, it just has me thinking about hindsight, the importance of black bodies at that time. You know, what was Trayvon Martin, Michael Brown, where was that stance when we needed it at that point? Those young African-American men who lost their lives. And I think at this point, we're trying to play catch up and do what's right. I think we're at this point in America where we're dealing with the brutality of human beings and also the moral compass of human beings. And I think the NFL is trying to be upon the moral compass, but there's just been so much hurt and pain and trauma along that road to them finding their enlightenment. And I think at this moment, if Colin Kaepernick is back in NFL, that's just a small step into what needs to be done and the steps each company needs to take in America to make right by the people of America.
Yeah. I said earlier at the beginning of the show at 10 o'clock about Roger Goodell. And I think it's a fair question. Like, what happened overnight? Why don't people know what's best? Like, what changed? You have a change of heart overnight? Like, what's behind that decision? I think that's a very fair question. What changed? Listen, you're calling on players to push the NFL to change its core values. What does that change look like, Michael?
I think that change is the sense of, like, well, we throw money in it, that's our moral obligation, and we're making change. I think that's not the steps that each team has to make, right? Each team has to go out and push for policy. I mean, the NFL alone is dealing with its own issue of race. And we talk about African-American coaches in the NFL and GMs, when you only have three head coaches, two GMs in the NFL that are African-American, when it makes up 70% of the 70% of the players are African-American descent. So we have our own issue that we're standing on. We're like a boxer with wobbly legs in the fourth quarter, right? And so, and we're trying to stay alive, but at the same time, we still got to deal with our own issues with the Rooney Rule. We literally have a rule that acknowledges that there's racial tension and racial issues when it comes to employments of African American players and coaches, right? And so, the teams have to be able to go out into these communities and really be a part of these communities and really make this change. What is each team's intent and its obligation to its society and its own community? And I think that's really the challenge that they have to find out. What are they going to do to make it the policy, right? Because it's this contradictory idea that, oh yeah, we believe in Black Lives Matter, but then we don't support, but we still support Donald Trump. You know what I'm saying? In a sense of, like, you can't have it both ways. Either we need to stand up and firm on the principles that we believe in, or either not have those principles and continue on the path that they've been on, rather than be hot and lukewarm. And I think this is the issue that they're having. And I think if you look at the Redskins, we literally have a team that has a racial slur. And I think that needs to be one of the things that's changed in the NFL also.
You mentioned President Trump suggesting this weekend that he won't watch the NFL if players kneel. Today, the Housing and Urban Development Secretary, Ben Carson, was asked if the president will change his stance on kneeling. This was his response, Michael. Watch.
Well, I don't think he has manifested as much animosity in that region lately. And I think we just continue to work with him. He'll get there.
Okay.
Yeah, it's really hard to hear Ben Carson saying that, knowing that he's an African-American man right now, right? We're dealing with... As a black man in America, as you see African American men on the street being killed, how could you say he'll get there?
And he called players sons of bitches. Like, this is a man, he said he hasn't garnered that much animosity. This is a man who called black players sons of bitches. Go on, sorry.
Yeah, so the steps to progression are really slow. And as an African American, we don't have time, the urgency for survival for people that look like us and people of color in this country. It's urgent right now. We're in a dire situation. This is why you see the riots on the street. This is why you see all these things. And this is why you see people across this country who have dedicated their lives to making change. And I think Ben Carson, he should know firsthand. I know that there's a struggle out there, and that the importance of athletes, the importance of every single person in this country standing up. This is beyond our fleshly battle at this moment. This is about spirituality and dealing with the spiritual wounds of America's history and reconciling with exactly the plight and the struggle and the traumatic experience of being Black in America.
Michael, Baker Mayfield saying that he's going to absolutely kneel after someone on Instagram implored him to tell Browns fans that he won't. And then J.J. Watt of the Texans making it clear that he supports kneeling after responding to a Twitter user who suggested that Watt won't kneel. Where is this newfound empowerment, this self-possession come from with NFL players? And not only just Black players, even white players now.
I think you've seen the situation when Colin Kaepernick was doing it. It was radical. It was the idea of standing against society and what was happening. It was a radical. So only a few people were doing it, but it feels like it's more being accepted and everybody wants to find a way to be inclusive and make an impact in these communities. And I think that's just what's happening right now. We live in a generation where we're seeing a lot of things happen socially. And I think Instagram and all these things are making impacts for people to see what is happening on every single social platform, the opportunities for people to be involved. And I think the white players are important to sharing the message and finding a way to make impact, because at the end of the day, this is about humanity. It's about the stakes is about reclaiming the humanity of the people of color in this country. And I think each human owes it to the next human to make sure that when we raise our children, that they can live in a safe world, that they can have opportunities in these schools, have fair medical treatment, and be the citizens. I believe life is a moral and spiritual freedom that is bestowed upon us by God, but not to be taken away from us by humans or the judicial system in American society.